Here's how to do a reaction table using volumes and concentration. The question reads, complete a reaction table in millimoles for the net reaction resulting when 35.3 mils of 0.125 molar NaCl and 28.4 mil of 0.0937 molar lead nitrate are mixed. Okay. In order to do the reaction table, we actually have to sort of know what reaction occurs. And hopefully from Chem 101, you remember that when you mix solutions of lead 2 plus aqueous and Cl minus aqueous, you will get lead chloride as a solid. So I'll put 2 in front of the Cl. Okay, when I do these problems, I like to write the amounts underneath each species because it helps me keep track of things. So underneath the lead, I will write 28.4 ml and 0.0937 molar. Underneath the chloride, I will write 35.3 ml and 0.125 molar. Okay, now we'll just multiply these out, and for the lead, initially it looks like I'm going to have 2.66 millimoles, 35.3 times 0.125 will give me 4.41 millimoles of chloride. Alright, now we might have to deal a little bit with a limiting reagent problem. Remember, to figure out the limiting reagent, you take the millimoles of material
and divide it by
the coefficient in front of that material to find out how many millimoles of reaction we can do. For lead, that turns out to be just a coefficient of 1. So we can do 2.66 millimoles of reaction there. For the chloride, that is 4.41 millimoles of chloride. The coefficient in front of the chloride is 2, so that gives us 2.205 millimoles of reaction. Okay. The lower one is a smaller value, so our chloride is our limiting reagent. So just like we did last time, we subtract all of our limiting reagent. And that would be on the delta row. All right, now, to figure out how much to subtract for the other materials, or add, remember that we divide by the coefficient. The ratio of lead to chloride is 1 to 2. So the amount of lead 2 plus that we consume must be 1 half, or 1 over 2, the amount of chloride that we consume. So I will put minus 2.21 here. And the same goes over here. It is 1 divided by 2, or plus 2.21. Okay. Now we just have to deal with the final row. For the lead, 2.66 minus 2.21 gives me 0.45. For the chloride, it's our limiting reagent, that's 0. And for lead chloride, we start out with none. We add 2.21, so when we're done, we have 2.21. millimoles. Okay, that's for the reaction table. The next question says, what mass of precipitate would form? Well, we know we have 2.2, and I'm just going to add an extra sig fig here. I know that 4.41 divided by 2 is actually 2.205. So just to make sure, you know, WebAssign doesn't get thrown off, I will put 2.205 millimoles of lead chloride. And of course, there are 1,000 millimole, I'm sorry, yes, millimoles in a mole, right? So we have to correct for that. And we can look up the molar mass of lead and chlorine and discover that the molar mass of lead chloride is 278.1 grams of lead chloride per 1 mole of lead chloride. All right, so millimoles are gone, moles. We are left with 0.613 grams of lead chloride. Last question. What is the molar concentration of the excess reactant? Okay, the excess reactant is lead 2+, and it's asking for the concentration. So let's look at the final row, and we notice that we have 0.45 millimoles, and now we need to divide it by our milliliters to get concentration, millimoles per milliliter. All right, we have, when we mixed, 28.4 mils, and 35.3 mils. So don't forget to go back and look at the mils that you mixed. Volumes are additive. Add those up, divide them into 0.45, and we discover that our concentration of lead is 7.06 times 10 to the minus 3 molar. That should work out pretty well.